circle the atom. Okay, now you're taking atom ATOM. Okay? So the atom is normally everybody thinks it like this. Okay? But this diagram is way far off. Then this part is way smaller and these things don't actually exist. Okay? So this is the simple version. Okay? Now, for a long time, people have thought that atoms were the uncuttable piece. Like if you had a piece of cheese and then you cut it in half and then cut that half into half and 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 half for a million times, you'll get the size of an atom. And to imagine what it is, take a hair, and the hair's width is almost nothing. Cut it the hair width in a half a million times, that's the shape of the atom, or the size of that. Okay? So this is that. For a long time, people thought it like this. Protons. Okay, protons have a positive charge. Negative. Neutrons have no charge. Okay? And electrons have negative charge. So, protons and electrons attract, but neutrons just hang out there. So now you're thinking, how is this thing put together? Like in a huge jumbled whatever you call it? No. It's grouped together this way. Okay, so there's a proton and a neutron. Okay? So, now you're doing where the electrons go here. Now you're doing there. They also should go in the, nucleus. No, they go around or spin or orbit around the nucleus. Okay? So they spin around the nucleus. So they spin around the nucleus quite fast. Okay, now to learn about the density. Okay, it's very light, the electron, and a proton, heavy. Trust me, it's really heavy. So because of the neutrons and protons, the nucleus contains 99% of the entire mass of the entire atom. Maybe more than 99%, okay? And this stuff, or electrons, very light, okay? So these are negatively charged. Okay, so the stage closest to the nucleus, or the shell, energy orbit, or energy shell, is called the ground state, okay? Ground state. And the one outermost from the atom is called the excited state, okay? Excited state. And the electrons in the outermost energy shell is called valence electrons, okay? So now here's how to display on the periodic table. This is whatever I'm doing over here is not the same element whatever it is. Okay? So let's think about Pu, plutonium. Its atomic number is 94 and its entire weight is 244. Okay, now you're wondering why the heck are these two numbers? This is the atomic number. And this is the mass So this is the electrons, not the electrons, neutrons and protons all together. And here is just the protons. If you want to figure out how many neutrons are there, just do 244 minus 94, you'll get how many neutrons are there in plutonium. Okay? So that's what that is. Now you're thinking, okay, so what are the atom is made out of protons, neutrons, and electrons, and there's a nucleus, and nucleus is made out of protons and neutrons. What are protons and neutrons made out of? Crazy, right? Here is what they're made out of. Okay, now, let us take a proton. Inside it, it has quarks. These small objects are the things that make up protons and neutrons. Okay? So that's what that is. Now they spin around and spin around. They never quit. In orbitals. Okay? In orbitals. This is called energy level. Now you're thinking maybe maybe 10 more could be fitted on this? No. In the first shell, only 2 electrons could be fitted. In the second shell, there are only 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? So this can hold 8 and more. It can only hold a fixed number of electrons. There's an infinite amount of shells you can go on and go on and go on, go on, go on forever. Okay? So these are, for a quick review, electrons, light, protons, heavy, neutrons, also heavy. Protons and neutrons are made of quarks. Protons has a, positive charge. Neutrons have no charge. Electrons have a negative charge. And that's all there is in an atom. Not to mention the quarks, okay? And now the proton and neutron are in the nucleus. The electrons are attracted to the nucleus because opposite attract. These are very small. They orbit around in energy shells or energy levels or whatever you want to call them. There's only a fixed number in each shell. For this example, the first shell is 2 electrons. The second shell is 8 electrons, yeah. And in plutonium, the atomic number is the number on top or any element. In this case, it's 94. And the number on the bottom is the mass number, which is 244, which is the protons. It's the protons plus the neutrons. Okay? Thank you.